Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the topic that is known as gears. So basically, gears are used for transmitting the motion from one location to another and transmitting the power from one shaft to another. That is the basic purpose of gear. So how one can define the gear? So a gear is a wheel with teeth on its outer edge. The teeth of one gear mesh or engage with the teeth of another. So basically, gear is nothing but a wheel, and on that wheel the teeth are cut on its outer periphery. That is nothing but gear. And the teeth of one gear, that is mesh, with the teeth of other. So mesh means engage. That means the teeth of one gear engage with the teeth of another gear. So here you can see the CAD model of gear. Here you can see the wheel, and on that wheel the teeth are cut on its periphery. And here in this image you can see two different gear. One is smaller gear and another one is larger gear, and the smaller gear is meshing with the larger gear. So here you can see the actual image of the gear. So here there are two gears, the upper gear and lower gear. The upper gear is a smaller gear, whereas the lower gear is a larger gear, and those two gears, they are meshing with each other. One more thing is there, these gears have teeth parallel to its own axis, and when the teeth are parallel to its own axis, then that type of gear is known as spur gear. So this is an example of spur gear. Now in gear there are two parts, driver and driven. So the gear which is attached to your motor, or the gear which is driving another gear, that is known as a driver gear. And driver gear is commonly attached to the main shaft, whereas driven gear is nothing but a gear which is attached to the driver gear and which is following the driver gear. That is known as driven gear. So two mesh gears always rotate in opposite direction. Whenever there are two gears, they are rotating or they are meshing with each other, they will rotate in opposite direction. So here you can see there are two gears, spur gear. So the gear at right hand side, that is the driver gear, and the gear at left hand side is driven gear. They are mounted on two different shafts and their teeth is parallel to its own axis. That is why it is known as spur gear. Now these two gears, they are meshing with each other and they rotate in opposite direction. So if the gear rotates in clockwise direction, the gear we will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. When there are only two gears, in that case those two gears will rotate in opposite direction. Now the idler gear. So here in this image you can see three different gears. The gear at the middle, that is known as idler gear. So here in this diagram you can see there are two gears, upper gear, lower gear and the middle gear. So the gear at the middle, that is known as idler gear, and it is basically used when you want to rotate two gears in the same direction. Because when two gears they mesh with each other, you will get a different direction. As I have already discussed, if the first gear rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the second gear will rotate in clockwise direction. If the first rotates in anti-clockwise, second will rotate in clockwise direction. But if you introduce idler gear in between those two gears, in that case those two gears will rotate in the same direction. So here in this animation you see gear, the upper gear that rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the middle gear rotates in clockwise direction, and the lower gear is rotated in anti-clockwise direction. That means the first and the last, or the upper and the lower gear, they are rotating in a same direction. So whenever there is requirement that the two gear rotates in the same direction, in that case you can introduce idler gear. Again, it will not affect the velocity ratio, because the velocity ratio depends on the velocity of the driver gear and the driven gear. So introduction of idler gear do not affect velocity ratio. Again, it can cover the distance. That means whenever you want to transfer the motion from one shaft to another and they are quite away from each other, In that case, you can introduce idler gear in between, because you cannot manufacture a larger gear and that will be very costly. So simply you can introduce idler gear in between them. So because of that, there will be no change in the velocity ratio, and you will be getting the same motion in the same direction. So that is the purpose of idler gear. So here you can see the upper gear is a driver gear, the lower gear is a driven gear, and the middle gear, that is known as idler gear. Now we will discuss the various types of gear train. So whenever there is two or more than two gears, they are meshing with each other, then it is known as gear train. And basically there are four types of gear train. So we will discuss one or two types of gear train in this video. So the very first type of gear train, that is simple gear train. So in this case, multiple gears can be connected together to form a gear train. That means whenever two or more than two gears, they are connected with each other, they are meshing with each other, it forms a gear train. So here in this diagram, you can see three different gears are there. They are mounted on three different shafts. So the first gear, that rotates in clockwise direction, the middle that rotates in anticlockwise direction, and the third one again rotating clockwise direction. So you can transmit the power from, say, first shaft to last shaft with the use of simple gear train. So each shaft carries only one gear wheel. So that is the basic condition for simple gear train. There should be only one gear on a shaft. There should not be more than one gear on a shaft. Otherwise, it will be compound gear train, that we will discuss later on. So there should be only one gear on a single shaft, then it is known as simple gear train. Intermediate gears are also known as idler gear. So idler gear I have already discussed. So those are nothing but intermediate gear. So this is an example of simple gear train. And here you have to keep in mind that there should be only one gear on a shaft. Now the another type, that is known as compound gear train. So if two gear wheels are mounted on a common shaft, then it is known as compound gear train. So if on a single shaft, if there are two gears, they are mounted, two gear wheels, they are mounted, then it is known as compound gear train. So here in this diagram, you can see a driver, then the compound gear. So the driver and compound gear, they are mounted on the same shaft, and the driven gear. So total there are only two shafts. On the first shaft, two gears are mounted, that is driver gear and compound gear. Whereas on the second shaft, only single gear is mounted, that is driven gear. So as on a single shaft, two gears are mounted, driver and compound gear. So they will rotate with same RPM. Whereas driven gear will rotate with different RPM. So here you can see a CAD model. So a larger gear is there, that is meshing with a middle gear, and on the middle shaft there are two gears, and then that is connected with third shaft. So here there are three shafts. On shaft 1, single gear is mounted. On shaft 2, two gears are mounted. On shaft 3, one gear is mounted, and you are transmitting the power from first shaft to the last shaft with the use of compound gear train. So here you have to keep in mind that there will be two gears mounted on a single shaft, that is first condition, and second one, those two gears will rotate with same RPM because they are mounted on a single shaft. They will not rotate with different RPM. So that is an example of compound gear train. So this is here you can see the simulation. So gear A, gear B, gear C, and gear D. So on shaft 1, only one gear is there, that is gear A. On shaft B, two gears are there, gear B and gear C. And on third shaft, a single gear is there, that is gear D. So you want to transmit the power from first shaft to the last shaft by introducing the compound gear. So on the second shaft, two gears are there. So second shaft will rotate, or the two gears will rotate with same RPM because they are mounted on a common shaft, that is shaft number 2. Now we will discuss what exactly the gear ratio is. So generally, the gear ratio is calculated by counting the teeth of two gear and applying the following formula. So the formula for calculation of gear ratio is gear ratio equal to number of teeth on driven gear divided by number of teeth on driver gear. So here in this animation, you can see two different gear. If the larger gear is say driver and the smaller gear is driven, in that case we can calculate the gear ratio as number of teeth on driven gear divided by number of teeth on driver gear. So this is the formula for calculation of gear ratio. So here you have to keep in mind that number of teeth on driven divided by number of teeth on driver, that will give the gear ratio. So we will take one numerical for calculation of gear ratio so that it will get clear. So a 100 teeth gear drives a 25 tooth gear. Okay, so there are two gears. On first gear there are 100 teeth and on second gear there are 25 teeth. Calculate the gear ratio for the machine teeth. So these are two different gears. On gear A there are 100 teeth and on gear B there are 25 teeth. Okay, so the formula is number of teeth on driven gear divided by number of teeth on driver gear. So here what we have assumed, driven gear is a smaller gear and driver gear is a larger gear. So the formula is number of teeth on driven gear. So number of teeth on driven gear is 25 and number of teeth on driver gear is 100. So 25 divided by 100, that is nothing but 1/4. So we can write the gear ratio as 1:4. That means there is a reduction in RPM by 1:4 because the RPM of gear depends on the number of teeth on the gear. As a number of teeth is more, the RPM will be less. As the number of teeth is smaller, the RPM will be more. So here we are reducing. Here we are increasing the speed as 1:4 because the driven gear is a smaller gear and driver is larger gear. So as the gear 1, that is as the driver gear completes 1 rotation, the driven gear will complete 4 rotation. That is nothing but gear ratio. Okay, so here the gear with 100 tooth, that is driver, and the gear with 25 teeth, that is driven. Okay, so that is the gear ratio. So as the gear 1, that is larger gear, completes 1 rotation, the gear 2 will complete 4 rotation. That is the use of gear ratio. Now we will discuss the calculation of gear speed. How to calculate the gear speed? Suppose two gears are given, okay, and if you want to calculate, and the speed of one gear is also given and the number of teeth on those two gears, that is also given. In that case you can calculate the RPM of or the speed of third gear, second gear. Okay, so just understand this case. Here there are two gears. So a motor gear has 28 teeth, that means it is a driver, and revolve at 100 revolution per minute. Okay, so number of teeth on driver, that is 28, and it is rotating with 100 revolution per minute. Then the driven gear has 10 teeth. So second gear has 10 teeth. What is the rotational speed? So here in this numerical, two gears are there. Number of teeth is also given. The number of teeth on driver, that is 28, and the number of teeth on driven is 10. Again the RPM of driver is given, that is 100, and we have to calculate the RPM of driven gear. So that can be calculated with the use of speed ratio. So speed ratio is nothing but number of teeth on driver divided by number of teeth on driven multiplied by revolution of driver. Okay, so we can calculate the speed of driven gear by using the formula, and the formula is speed of driven gear equal to number of teeth on driver gear divided by number of teeth on driven gear multiplied by speed of driver gear. So here the number of teeth on driver, that is 28, number of teeth on driven is 10, multiplied by speed of driver, that is 100. So by doing calculation you can get the answer, that is 280 revolution per minute. And why it is more? Because the driver gear has more number of teeth, whereas the driven gear has less number of teeth. So your speed will increase. So here the driver gear is rotating with 100 rpm, whereas the driven gear is rotating with 280 rpm, nearly 2.5 times the driver gear. Okay, so with the use of this formula we can calculate the gear speed. Now we will discuss worm gear and wheel. Okay, there are various types of gear, like we have discussed the spur gear. In spur gear the teeth of the gear are parallel to its axis, that is known as spur gear. Another type is worm gear and wheel. So the worm gear is always the drive gear. Okay, so this is an example of worm and wheel. Okay, so worm is in the form of shaft, and wheel is, you can see. So in simulation you can see one wheel is there, that is nothing but wheel, worm wheel we can say, and one shaft is there, that is known as worm. Okay, and the worm gear is always a drive gear, that you have to keep in mind. So here we are converting rotary motion into rotary motion itself, but here the worm gear will be always a drive gear. So this is an example of worm gear and wheel. So through simulation it is get clear now, and one image is also given on the screen. Then rack and pinion, this is also another type of gear. So the rack and pinion gear is used to convert between rotary and linear motion. If you want to convert rotary motion into a linear motion, or a linear motion into rotary motion, in that case you can use rack and pinion arrangement. So here in this simulation you can see a rack will have a linear motion always, it will reciprocate only. Okay, so rack is nothing but a linear gear, or the teeth are cut linearly over a plate, that is nothing but rack, and that is attached with the pinion. So with this arrangement you can convert a linear motion into rotary motion. As the rack reciprocates, that means it has a linear motion, that you can convert into rotary motion of the pinion, or you can convert the rotary motion of the pinion into linear motion of the rack. So this is an example of rack and pinion. So here the rack and pinion is also used in car jack also. Then the last type, that is known as bevel gear. So bevel gears are used to transmit the drive through an angle of 90 degree or other than 90 degree also. Spur gear we can use only when the two shafts they should be parallel to each other, then and then we can use spur gear. But if the two shafts they are not parallel to each other and they are making certain angle, or they are perpendicular to each other, in that case we can use bevel gear. Okay, so this is an example of bevel gear. Here the two shafts they are perpendicular to each other. Okay, so through this image and through this simulation you can understand the arrangement of bevel gear. So here the two shafts they are perpendicular to each other, and now you want to transmit the power. In such case you cannot use spur gear, you have to use bevel gear. That means the bevel gears are used whenever the two shafts they are making 90 degree or other than 90 degree angle. In that case bevel gears are used. So I hope you have understood most of the parts of gear and gear train. Thank you so much for watching my lecture. Thank you.